I would like to start today's discourse from Ma's Vani. Ma tells the question, any question it may be, it arises in the mind because you are. Because you are, so there is a question. And as you know, question is always presented or asked in words, through mind, with the help of words, you put in the question, and the answer you get, it is also in words, and you get it, you understand it through mind. The question and answer both belong to a thought pattern. Both are thoughts. Ma says this process of questioning and answering will never end. Because it is all mental. If you want a real answer, then you have to transcend the mind. You have to go beyond thought process, beyond mind. There lies the true answer. So this should be our direction of seeking the answer, to go beyond mind. Because there lies the true answer, then you are totally satisfied in forever. Otherwise, you will go on questioning, go on getting answering, it will never end. So we should keep this in mind, that to get the real answer, which leaves no possibility for next question, that we can get only in the silence of truth. Through practice of meditation, our mind can be silent. We may achieve a state in which there is no thought. Still, it is not the true answer, because it is a state of mind. You are in mind, and to get the real answer, you have to transcend mind, you have to go beyond mind. So that should be your direction of effort. That should be your goal, to transcend mind and to reside in reality, which is beyond everything, beyond mind and matter. That is your question is that through intellect or mind, we reach the state of non-duality. We have this conviction that all is God. So it is a thought process. Now your question is, it is because it is intellectual, how can it lead to the reality which is not of the mind? It comes in the field of our effort to have correct understanding through the help of mind or intellect. When we have reached that state of understanding where no question arises and we are in full conviction that reality is non-dual, everything is one, all is God. So, to this point we can reach through the help of mind. Now, our prasad, our effort and seer we are to stay in this state. That's all. Further, in this state of mind, God's grace descends, and then you transcend the mind. There comes the answer.
Okay.
That reality is manifested. So it means, in a realization, both are required. Your effort plus grace. Effort also has a value, because without mind, you cannot have this understanding, this conviction, this state of mind, which tries to grasp the oneness of everything. Through mind you reach it. Once you have attained it, then God starts His work.
Mm.
His grace comes to us.
Mm.
And then this state of mind, it disappears, and we are one with the reality, which is real even. It is not a thought of mind. It is not a thought of non-duality, of oneness. It is not a thought process. It reality is as it is. Then, as Ma says, you cannot call it duality or non-duality, one or many. You have gone beyond it. Na vaha dvait hai, na vaha advait hai, na vaha ek hai, na vaha anek hai. So Ma defines Vedanta, you know. Once someone put a question before Ma, what is Vedanta? Ma says, Bhed abhed ka jahan ant. Vedanta is, there is no difference and there is also non-difference. No non-difference also. Bheda bheda, both. Duality as is non-duality, both disappear. It is Vedanta. This is Ma's definition. So this is Vedanta. You have gone beyond even oneness. Oneness is the greatest achievement of mind, the mind can achieve, the highest. So by effort you have to reach that point first. Through His grace only you can make any effort. You have desire for truth, it means grace is there, or it is working there. Otherwise you could not have desire. So grace is there from the first step to the last. Bolo.
Are there any conditions for grace to descend?
The real condition is our aspiration, our longing for God, our curiosity, our desire. That is the most promising condition of God realization. There should be real hunger, thirst for knowledge, for truth. If there is thirst, then God will work, He will help.
But that is already a God gift, this hunger.
What?
The hunger for God, it's already gift of God.
So we have to pray. If this gift is given by Him, this hunger, then we have to pray for it. We should ask Him that let us have real hunger, real thirst for Him. He will listen.
When the highest state of mind is this oneness, so in this oneness, how this desire will come?
No. Our effort ends there. Then we are not to desire anything. We should reside only in that state. In that oneness we should stay. That is enough. Then desire is not required. The desire, the purpose of desire, that we reach this state of mind of oneness. Our effort ends there. And God knows what to do then. He will do.
Vama, in today's Madhuri Vani reading in Hindi, there were so many deep points. Did I understand correctly? At one point it said, Ma said that the Guru is doing the sadhana.
Yes.
Only we're just sitting, but the Guru is actually doing it.
Right, right. That is correct attitude. We should not take diversity within us. Very most important point in the field of sadhana. We should not take doership. It is God who is within us as Jeev. Now, this Jeev, who is God Himself, wants to release Himself. Jeev is God, and God in the form of Jeev is having this desire that I should get released, I should get liberation, emancipation. Desire comes first. Then there is effort. Now, who is making effort? He himself. God is making effort to release himself. It goes on. And ultimately, who gets it? God gets it. God realizes Himself that all along it was God alone who desired, who made effort, now who has realized and become free. This whole play from bondage to liberation, it is related to God only, not to us. This we should keep in our mind. So भगवान हमारे भीतर साधक के रूप भगवान ही साधक है the aspirant within us is God, not we. वो ही साधना कर रहा है और वो ही अपने को प्राप्त करता है. That is why Ma says भगवान अपने को लेकर के खेल रहा, अपने को लेकर के खेल रहा. अब देखो, try to understand these words of Ma. God is playing with himself. So God is sadhak and God is siddh. God is in bandhan, God is in moksha, in the form of moksha. This is God's play. So in sadhana we should have this attitude. It is God who is playing. इसलिए ये बहुत important point है. कर्म से भगवान की प्राप्ति नहीं होती. Through effort, through action, we cannot realize God. But if that action, that effort is accepted as God, then that effort, that action can lead us to God. Because it is God who is in the form of action and effort.
Only through God can we attain God.
It is God's longing for God,
yes,
that we're talking about, but the experience of not longing must also be God's. Yeah.
Certainly. When we accept this attitude that everything is God, then that too is a form of God. But it makes us suffering. It leads to suffering. That suffering too is a form of God, but we want to avoid it. We want to get rid of it. So this longing, that too is God.
Because I'm only concerned with trying to increase my longing, not my longing, but the longing for God. It's my
pukar ko badhana cha rahe hain, yehi inka prayas hai.
Yes. Yeah. So this can be done through prayer. Right. We should pray to Him.
If we long for God, then our work is finished.
Go on praying
for longing.
And no one knows, only God knows, which call will reach to Him and He will make response. So we should, our effort should be calling, praying and praying. That should go on. There are five Mahavakyas of Ma. One is this. Out of the five, one is this. Apne ko pana, mane Bhagwan ko pana. To realize self is to realize God. And to realize God is to realize self. Because both are one. If you get one, you get another also. Because God and self both are one. अपने को पाना भगवान को पाना अपने को जानना भगवान को जानना अपने को जानना इफ यू नो गॉड यू आल्सो नो योरसेल्फ एंड इफ यू नो योरसेल्फ यू आल्सो नो गॉड इन द पाथ ऑफ नॉलेज वी नो फर्स्ट अवरसेल्फ एंड देन वी नो गॉड इन द पाथ ऑफ डिवोशन फर्स्ट वन नोस गॉड एंड ही इवेंचुअली ही नोस हिमसेल्फ आल्सो
And the other four?
And?
The other four Bhakyas of Ma.
What is Ekam Brahm Dityaya Nasti? These are the five Mahavakyas of Ma. First is Ekam Brahm Dityaya Nasti. Brahman is one, there is no other. This is first one. Second, jahan ek Brahma bodh hai, wahan kuch chhutta nahi. Where there is experience of oneness of truth, nothing is left there. This is second. Matlab, God is all inclusive. Totally. This is second. Third, apne ko pana, mane Bhagwan ko pana, Bhagwan ko pana, mane apne ko pana. To attain oneself is to attain God, to attain God is to attain oneself. Third. Fourth, sab Bhagwan hai, all is God. Everything is God.
Singular statement.
Fourth. Fifth. Bhagwan hai, jo kaho wahi. Ek aur anant. What is God then? Ma says, Bhagwan hai, jo kaho wahi. Whatever you say, that it is. Whatever you conceive, that it is. Ek aur anant, one and infinite. जो कहोगे दिस इज मास्ट गॉड्स डेफिनेशन एंड परहैप्स द बेस्ट डेफिनेशन वन कैन गिव अ गॉड टू जो कहोगे नो वन हैज डिफाइंड इन दिस वे गॉड इज इन वट एवर वे यू कंसीव दैट इट इज वट एवर यू से वट एवर यू थिंक दैट इट इज दिस इज गॉड एवरी अदर डेफिनेशन ऑफ गॉड लिमिट्स हिम इफ यू से गॉड इज दिस It means God is not there, but God is there also. So there can be, if there is any other definition, it will limit God. Only this is the definition of Ma, which is perfect, complete, total, whole. Whatever you say, God is there. These are five Mahavakyas. In every book, perhaps I have given these. With mass short by Bhati. Or 40 Sajana. As it happened in the case of Ramana Maharshi.
As an audience.
Realization took place, but he did not know what it is. Jab unke samne Ridhu Gita ka paath hua, then he understood, Are, I am already in this state. Now see, this is the difference between understanding and realization. Suppose उसको कोई थियोरेटिकल नॉलेज नहीं है एंड और बिकॉज ऑफ हिज एस्पायरेशन स्ट्रॉन्ग डिजायर गॉड्स ग्रेस डिसेंड्स अपॉन हिम एंड ही रियलाइजेस नाउ सी व्हाट हैपेंस इन दिस रियलाइजेशन बिकॉज देयर इज नो माइंड देयर इज नो थॉट इट इज टोटली अ साइलेंस स्टेट ही साइलेंस हिज माइंड इज नॉट वर्किंग एट ऑल देन टू अंडरस्टैंड This thing, one needs mind. And mind is not there. So he will not understand.
But beyond mind है experience. तो फिर mind क्यों चाहिए?
Mind इसलिए चाहिए. If someone asks you, how will you answer?
अच्छा, if someone asks.
If there is a question you cannot answer, so understanding is also required to answer others, to make clear. Musa, Hazrat Musa.
Musa.
When he was passing through, he saw a bush burning on a mountain. Then he saw the bush is there, this fire is there, but bush is not burning. What can be the reason? So he bent here. He listened to a voice. Put off your shoes there. You don't come in this holy place. Usne juta utara. Then he bent here. And then he said, Hazrat Musa asked, who are you? Then the voice came, I am the father of your generation. Or, I am the father, I am the protector, I am the savior. Now I have come to save this race. And if tell to the race, your people, that I will save them, for this I have manifested myself. Then Hazrat Musa put a question before him, if I go to the people you are asking to go, how will you introduce you? Who are you? Then God said, with the voice came, you tell them, I am is my name. And I am has sent you to the earth. This is very deep. It's similar to the expression Brahmadaranyaka Upanishad. There was first God, or Brahman. He said first, I am, aham asmi. Aham asmi, I am. Now this similarity, see the similarity of both these statements. So I am is the first name. And that comes to you. You also say, I am. So first name, a God's name. This is your name. So God and you, as I am, are one. No difference. The Christianity, as well as Hinduism, both agree on this point. This I am is one. So you get this point. I am. And who are you? What is your name? You say, I am so and so. This so and so, this is the obstacle. This is the parda. Ma says, avran, parda, laga liya. So, you parda laga liya, we have put a curtain before it. What is that curtain? So and so. This is the curtain. You have to remove this. Because God has not told you that you are this and this. They are the parents who have given this name. But God has real name. The God has given, what is the name? I am. I am is God's name. You catch hold it. This is a real name. And if you take this name, then you will become free. There is no binding with I am. There is a bonding with so and so. Yes. God, this is God's first name. So first you tell, I am. Matlab, you are giving your introduction to her. As God, I am. And soon you become Jeev, so and so. So you introduce yourself as both. As the God, as well as Jeev, individual person. But to feel this, it is a very long habit to identify this I am with this body, with our thought, with our mind, everything. So this habit should go. In meditation, we should try to learn to stay with simple I am, without adding any other name, any other factor, attribute. Simple I am. We should try to learn with I am, plus I am. Yes. Then we are with God. This I am is God. God has told this. I am is my name. I am, I am. It is, I am is my form. I am is my name. So how simple it is. God is always with you.
Baba, I find sometimes...
But you cannot see because this, you identify immediately this I am with this body. Immediately you identify. But this is to be corrected. Alright, you are following? Mantra Ashto is the extension of I am. I am is the first mantra. this I am is manifested as a second step in mantra. So those who cannot directly catch hold of I am, they are suggested that, well, don't identify with this name of physical body, but just try to catch hold a mantra, a holy name, because that too is God's name. But through this God's name, secondary, through this secondary name of God, you will reach to the primary name, which is I am. And this I am will merge in what you cannot see.
So that will merge.
You become silence then. In silence it will merge, ultimately.
It will merge.
Because from silence it has emerged. I am has come from silence. In silence it will return, that it is source. Then you are one with God.
In meditation.
No, you have translated even oneness. Because in I am you have oneness, you have realization of oneness of God.
Mm-hmm.
But when this I am returns to the source, which is silence, uh-huh, then everything is gone.
Okay.
He remains as it is. Bhagavan hai jo ko bhai, he is what he is. Then you reach that. Tat. This is called Tat in Vedas.
Deho.
As it is, ya jata. He is what he is. Reality as it is. It is a problem of every sadhak to fight with mind. You sit for meditation, but very soon your thoughts occupy your mind. Though you don't want, but they come. And you feel disturbance. You cannot meditate. It becomes very difficult. What to do? This is the problem with everyone. My approach to this problem is unique. Unique in this way. That she does not tell you to get rid of that thought. She tells, when there is such a disturbance because of thought or because of any noise outside, anything may be a reason for it, whenever this is thing, then you put a question before you, before mind, who in this form, who in the form of disturbance, who in the form of problem, struggle, who? When you put this question, and at that time you remember my words, it is God. It is God who has appeared as thought. And then that thought, that disturbing element inside or outside, it does not remain your enemy, because we have accepted it as God, and you accept it, it will go. This is what Maharaj told. This is the most positive approach to the problem. Otherwise you go on fighting, I don't want, but it will come. It will not listen to you. It is his will, you go on coming. And you fight, you make a struggle, more and more disturbance, more and more struggle, it will go on. So how to meet? Go on accepting. If noise is coming, God is coming in the form of noise. It's some memory which is very bitter, it is coming to the mind. This memory, who in this form? God. It is not memory, it is God, manifestation of God. Some imagination, who? God in that form. Some planning, God in that form. Anything, whatever comes to the mind, just to accept it as mind, as God, and go on accepting, then the problem will no more be a problem, but a help towards reaching the real goal. Christopher, is that right?
I
I think.